Yo, YouTube, what's going on? Tech King Mike back with another video for you guys. And yes, man, it is officially 2023. We are in the building. And guys, man, I still am rocking with the Galaxy Z Fold 3. Now, me and this phone have gone back and forth. It's been kind of a love-hate relationship over the last several months. But I wanted to give you guys kind of like a four-month review with this device. Now, if you guys saw my original videos on the channel about this phone, you know that I initially started with the gray-green color. But due to some issues that I had with that device, sorry for how dirty this is. I do take it to work with me every day, so this is what your screen's going to look like. But due to some issues I had with that device, I ended up having to send it back. And I ended up going with the black instead. So I can take the back of this part off the case. And you guys can get an idea of that black. That's actually kind of like better, if I'm being 100% honest with you. The black just is a little bit more of a sleeker look to me. The gray-green is a really nice color, but the black is just something about it. But anyway, man, this Galaxy Z Fold 3, I've been using this phone off and on consistently for about the last 4 months. I have switched between this phone, the Pixel 7 Pro, the iPhone 14 Pro Max, and those have been the main three phones that I kind of go back and forth with. Shout out to Team Pixel, Pixel 7 Pro in the building. This phone has really taken my mind off of a lot of devices. And the reason for that is after 4 months of use with this phone, again, this is not the particular one that I started with, but nonetheless, I still have it. After 4 months of using a Fold off and on, I can honestly say that, like, I'm glad I decided to really give folding phones a try last year. Not a try as in I bought it for the channel or because, you know, I thought it'd be cool to be able to do this in front of people all the time. Like, I actually decided to really see what life would be like to use a folding phone as my everyday phone. And I gotta be honest with you, man, I have really enjoyed my experience. Now, this right here is just a little microfiber cloth that I got from a screen protector that I applied, but I'm gonna use it to try to clean off the screen just a little bit for you guys. But while I'm doing that, I'm gonna talk about some of the uses that I found myself using this phone for. So, like, one of the biggest ones is when I travel, I don't feel the need to carry my laptop anymore. Now, I have an old Razer Blade 15. It's just the base model. I did see the new Razer Blade 16s that were just announced, and I really am interested in one, but that'll probably be next year. This phone has truly taken the place of, like, my everyday carry as far as, like, when I travel or just in general. I don't feel the need to buy a tablet. I actually like the candy bar style on the outside. I feel like it's perfect for any kind of browsing, apps, anything I want to do as far as texting. It's a really great design, and I really feel like with this little 3 extra millimeters that they added this year really made a difference to me. It's actually really come a long way. The other thing that I enjoy is that we did get some upgraded cameras this year. Now, of course, they're still not ultra cameras, you know, with the air quotes, because people want the best cameras that they can get out of a Samsung device, and you can't really blame them for that. I too want the best cameras that I can get, but I think we have to really just kind of take it in perspective that the Ultra comes out at the beginning of the year, and this has officially taken the place of the Note with the mid-year release. And quite frankly, I always thought that the Note had better cameras. Now, they were always a variation of the Ultra's cameras, but still, I have not had a problem with these cameras. Do you deal with the Samsung shutter lag? Yes, but it is not the end of the world for me. It's not something that I feel is just so horrible that I can't make it work. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to actually just take a picture here real quick. I just, like I said, just recently did a little reset, but I'm going to grab my remote here for my light, and we're just going to just going to move my hand while I'm taking the picture. And as you guys can see, the photos are a little, obviously they're shaky because I'm shaking my hand, but for the most part, the focus is there. The focus is not that bad. I mean, obviously these two are, yeah, they're pretty bad, but still, the focus is not that bad. I think in the grand scheme of things, these cameras are really good. They are far more than what the average person is going to really need. And I really think that unless you're just one of those people that just really wants to just nitpick and just find reasons to not like something, these cameras on this device are going to suffice for you just fine. They get the job done for me. I am perfectly fine recording videos of my daughter, one-year-old running around. I'm perfectly comfortable taking pictures of her while she's doing stuff. I have never once thought, I don't want to use this phone because it doesn't record video like an iPhone or it doesn't take pictures like a Pixel. It gets the job done. And then, of course, there's this inner display. Now, okay, elephant in the room, the crease. Yes, the crease. After 4 months, off and on altogether, the crease is still a factor. Does it bother me? No. And the reason why is because I understand Samsung's need for it. Samsung has gone on record multiple times to say, we have this crease to add to the water resistance. Now, for me, that is a necessity. I would love to try out one of the folding phones that are coming out from overseas in the China market. But for me, this is a necessity. I have to have water resistance on my device. I work outside majority of the day, and I've been caught in downpours that you wouldn't imagine in northeastern Florida. And I just could not see myself using any device that does not have some form of water resistance. I would say the only thing that I'm just really concerned about on a durability standpoint with the Z Fold 4 would be the dust resistance, dust and dirt. Now, of course, we know that there's microfiber, bristles, brushes lined in the hinge. And that's why when you open and close it, you know, you can have a dusty pocket. I have pockets for work that are way deeper than they need to be. And the phone is usually in that pocket all day. And as you guys can see from the dust and stuff that's on the phone, it gets pretty bad. I mean, I'm outside in the dirt as well. And it just, for whatever reason, I can't get away from it. But the phone is fine. My gray green model that I had before, I had to send it back. And even this one so far and the uses that I've had have been just fine. I haven't had a single problem with them. Would I like Samsung to give us a 100% IP68 dust and water resistance? Of course I would. But in the meantime, I will take what I have because I feel like this is going to be just fine. Now, another con that I will say is the battery life. Now, you're going to hear a lot of people tell you that, oh my God, the battery got so much better. And it did. The battery was refined on these devices a lot. But as you can see right now, it's currently 9:24 p.m., 9:25, and I'm at 54%. Took my phone off the charger this morning. Let's go to settings, and we'll see when exactly we took the phone off the charger. I believe I took it off the charger this morning around 6 a.m. or so. Let's see. So we took it off the charger. Let's see. So screen on time today is 1 hour and 20 minutes, but it's been in use 13 hours and 59 minutes. Now, screen on time is one of those things that's subjective to me. 54% is really good. But if this was a day, say, where I was actually like really trying to use it, I'm going to go ahead and pull up. Let's see. Believe it may have been this day here where my screen on time was 4 hours and 33 minutes. And then on another day where my screen on time was 5 hours and 22 minutes, the battery, I ended up having to charge it. You can see right here where I had to charge it midway through the day at work because my battery literally got to 20%. So obviously, I mean, I was really on shopping messages and things like that. But the bottom line is, if you push this phone, it will drain fast. And it's not a bad thing. Just always have a charger handy when you get ready to use one. On the subject of battery and power, this phone has handled everything I've thrown at it. I have successfully done cloud gaming through Xbox on this thing. I have done regular mobile gaming. I've streamed on this phone as far as watching streams and just YouTube videos constantly. I even have edited not a video for YouTube, but a little personal project I did as well that I didn't have any problem with on the Z Fold 4. And it just continuously gets the job done. I've got a Samsung smart monitor in my bedroom, and I use this phone with Dex sometimes when I don't feel like hooking up my Razer, you know, because I keep my Razer around the house. And Dex is just continuing to get better. I like that it's continuing to just find ways to fine-tune the desktop experience. What I wish we could get on the Z Fold 5 would be maybe a Dex interface on the home end screen, you know, like on this inner display. That would actually be really nice. But overall, the Z Fold 4 has been a great device. I think if I had to put a wish list together for the Z Fold 5, of course, like I said, I would love to see a Dex interface like on the Tab S8 Ultra or the Tab S8 Plus. I'd love to see a Dex interface for this inner display. Maybe get this camera here to be a little bit better or even get rid of this camera. I mean, it's not the end of the world, but I would just like to see something better. It's good for video calls, but that's about it. Like, you don't really need it for anything else. Video calls, that's about it. That's all it's good for. Maybe even give us, you know, go ahead and give us those ultra cameras. That would be really nice to have as well. But I think the biggest thing for me would just be to just continue to fine tune the overall experience of the device. The taskbar that we get when we open up certain apps. Let me go ahead and just show you guys that taskbar. I'm going to go to Twitter. I'm going to pop Twitter open. And then let's just go to YouTube Music.
And having this task bar at the bottom is really nice. And I think it's really dope that you can just kind of have so many different apps running at the same time when you're using this phone. It's one of those things that I never thought I'd be one of the people who ranted and raved about it, but it is what it is, man. I really and truly love using this phone, man. I've just grown to really enjoy it. It's become one of my companions that I can't see myself without. And I think if you can get one on a good deal, used on Swappo, refurbished on eBay, or if you can just take advantage of one of Samsung's many trade-in deals that they offer, I don't think that you'll go wrong trying out the Z Fold 4. Is it for everybody? I don't think so. I think this is a very niche product still, and I think it's one of those products that people are still going to have to really warm up to if they're deciding to get one. But I do think that it's a good product if you give it a try. Maybe this year we'll get a chance to put it up against some of those competing foldables over on the Chinese market. You know, the Oppo Find N2, the Vivo X90 Pro Plus, whatever the Vivo X Fold is going to be. You know, like maybe we can get a chance to try it against some of those this year. But for now, Z Fold 4 is still the best foldable for me, in my opinion. And I'm really enjoying my experience with it so far. So stay tuned for more videos on the channel. And man, I hope you guys are enjoying yourselves. Happy New Year again. Hope everybody had a great holiday. Glad to see you all here. Glad we all made it through another crazy year. Feels like 2020 is still going on, but we're here. And yeah, man, Z Fold 4. Gonna go ahead and get up out of here, man. Thanks for watching. Hope you guys enjoyed yourselves. Tech King Mike. Peace.